What's up guys, Jojo Braced here. In this video, we're going to have another GeoGebra tutorial. In this video, we're going to approximate the area of a circle using an inscribed polygon. So basically, we will draw a circle with a radius 1 and then inscribed a polygon with side n, where n is a slider. So we will observe what happens if we increase the value of n. Okay, so let's start. To start off, we draw the center of our circle using the point tool. So I go to the point tool, and then click on the origin, and then I want a circle with radius 1. So instead of using the circle with center point tool, we will use the second tool, which is the center, or the circle, center and radius. And then we click on A and type 1 as its radius. Next, we use the zoom in tool to enlarge our circle. Actually, this is not enlarging, but this is just zooming in. The circle still has a radius 1, right? We don't want the grid, so we can just click the style bar and hide the grid. Next, we draw the second point, which is at 1, 0. Now, point B will be one of the vertices of our inscribed polygon. Next, for the number of sides, we use a slider. And to do that, we select the slider tool, click on the graphics view. We want an integer slider where the minimum value is 3. 3 is for a triangle. And maybe the maximum value, set to 100. And then we click the OK button. Next, we calculate the, if this is one vertex of our polygon and this is another vertex somewhere here, we have to calculate the central angle. Okay. So to calculate the central angle, the entire circle is 2 pi, and then we divide 2 pi by n. Okay. So CA for central angle is equal to 2 pi over n. Okay. Next, we rotate B about A, whatever the value of CA here. That's the amount of rotation. So to do that, we go to the rotate around point tool and then click on B, click on A, and then for the angle, just type CA. So whatever the value of CA is. Leave the button to counterclockwise. And there you go. So this is my second vertex. B prime is my second vertex. Now to draw the polygon, the inscribed polygon, I will use the regular polygon tool. So I click that and then click on B and then B prime. And then for the number of vertices, I just type n, so whatever the value of n. Okay. And let's see what happens if we increase n. Okay. So we want to approximate the area of the inscribed polygon. I guess this time we won't be needing the coordinate axis, so we just click on the graphics view and then hide the coordinate axis by clicking this icon. Next, we also won't be needing the point here, point A, so just right click and then show object. And instead of the name, we display the value, which is the area of the polygon. So we can right click and then select settings. And then in the settings window, we go to the basic tab. And then in the show label checkbox, we choose value. Value is the area of the polygon, right? So from here, it doesn't say much, like if n is 100, or I think from n equals 59 or is it 56? It's already 3.14 and the value does not change. So it doesn't say much, but if we change, we increase the decimal numbers, we can see what happens. So to increase the decimal numbers, we go to style bar, and then we click the gear icon. And here you can see another gear icon here. So you just click this, and then for the rounding, you increase the number of decimal places. Like if you want 5 decimal places, then I guess that's fine, right? So as n increases, what happens to the value of what happens to the area of the polygon? Actually, it approaches pi. So I think that's the thing that we want our students to discover. Of course, you can increase the number of vertices here. You can probably set to 500 if you want. And as we increase, of course, the value here approaches a pi. Now, for the labels, I can't really find a way to. I can't really find a way yet on how to hide the labels except by doing it one by one. So maybe if you know a way, you can comment on the video below, in the comment section below. Okay, that's it. That's inscribing a polygon in a circle. I hope you have learned something. I would like to invite you to subscribe to my channel. And please invite your friends. I'll see you in the next video.